Welcome, dear people. Welcome, beloved ones, to my channel, a channel about life and a channel about death. Now, when I say death, I upload at night a lot of paranormal videos, and I do it to help me and to prove that life goes on. And I am trying different things with this channel. I am trying to attract varied audiences, and I'm trying to grow my audience. I've found that this has become a bit of an addiction for me, because originally I started this channel and it was talking about my addiction and it was talking about helping people. But I've kind of moved past that, and I'm hoping that one day when I move away from here, that I'll set up and I'll have some more technology and it'll be much more interesting. But much recently, my channel has tried to be funny, you know, that sense of humor. So I have just got a little speech here for you. So if it's not funny, let me know and I'll give up, okay? Because I'm no comedian. So I'm going to say, ladies and gentlemen, esteemed guests, and you are my esteemed guests, and I'm very honored to have you, and fellow aficionados of humor. Today, I'm sitting before you with the lofty task of tickling your funny bones and brightening your spirits. Now, I must admit that I am no stand-up comedian, but I shall try to endeavor to share a few chuckle-worthy antidotes and observations from the pages of life itself. So please, prepare yourselves for a journey through the land of silliness and truth. Have you ever noticed that escalators have a way of revealing our most peculiar behavior? I mean, they're essentially moving stairs, not high-speed roller coaster, but the moment we step onto one, it's as if we've become contestants on a game show called Let's Race the Escalator. It's a race where somehow our legs transform into those of Olympic sprinters. And heaven forbid, if someone overtakes us on the adjacent escalator, it's like challenging our very existence. So next time you're on an escalator, just remember, it's not the Indy 500. Now let's talk about technology. The marvels that both amaze and perplexes. Have you ever received an automated phone call that starts with press 1 for English, press 2 for dash dash dash, and the list goes on? It's like deciphering a secret code while trying to figure out which button will lead you to an actual human being. And if you dare to press the wrong number, it's as if the automated system suddenly turns into your over-enthusiastic friend who says, "Oh, I see, you're having trouble. Let's start from the beginning." "No, please, not the beginning again. I already know how to speak English in 7 languages." Speaking of languages, let's talk about autocorrect, the mischievous gremlin that turns your well-composed message into a cryptic puzzle. You've probably experienced the dreaded autocorrect corrections that turn your innocent sentences into something hilariously awkward. I once tried to text my friend, "Let's meet at the park," but thanks to autocorrect, it became, "Let's meet, M-E-A-T, at the pork, P-O-R-K." Well, I hope they like barbecue. Now let's delve into the enigma of grocery shopping. You know that feeling when you got into a store for just one item, say a carton of milk, and emerge with a cart overflowing with goodies. It's like entering a magical portal where your shopping list turns into mere suggestions. You think you're walking down the pasta aisle, but suddenly you find yourself in the chocolate section and you can't quite remember how you got there. It's as if the grocery stores are designed by mischievous elves who sprinkle extra shopping ideas along the way. Oh, you need eggs. Well, have you considered this artisanal cheese and imported jam? Now, let's take a moment to appreciate the art of multitasking. We all pride ourselves on our ability to do several things at once, but let's be honest. When we try to juggle too many tasks, it often feels like we're participating in a circus act where the balls we're juggling are actually flaming torches. So, if you see me balancing a coffee cup, a laptop, and a phone, just know that I'm not a multitasking virtuoso. I'm just one step away from joining the circus. In conclusion, dear friends, life is a parade of silliness and truth, a whirlwind of escalator races, technological mishaps, linguistic misadventures, unexpected grocery treasures, and the illusion of multitasking mastery. Let's embrace these absurdities, for they remind us that even in the most serious of moments, a hearty laugh can be the best companion. May your days be filled with laughter, and may your escalator races always bring you joy. And I hope you win. And for heavens forbid, if you're standing on an escalator, on the same escalator, and someone tries to get past you, whoa! Yes. So thank you. And remember, if life gives you auto-corrected lemons, make some pork lemonade. Love to you. Cherish every moment. Love the best you can. And I hope that you did have a giggle. And remember, I love you, and that's the best I can do for the moment. But please leave a comment. If you're tired of humour, I'll find something serious for us to discuss. All right, have a great Friday. Lots of love. Take care. This video is now done. Bye.